Jenny?
Yeah?
Are you excited about tonight?
Yay, very excited. Last show. Can't believe it. 42nd show for me.
Your husband can have it back after tonight.
This is like my world now, so it's going to be funny for it to end. So, anyway, all good things have to come to an end. But
yeah. That's right.
We'll be back next time.
2019, yeah.
Are you worried when you hear about the next tour coming?
Oh, God, yeah. Yeah. No, absolutely. I'm waiting for Madonna to retire. That's what I want, you know.
Reap what you sow, find what you seek. I am the sorceress down in the deep. I am the earth under your feet. I am the moon with no light of my own. You are the sun, guarding your throne.
Sometimes you worry, you know, I mean, she'll be away in some backwater of Eastern Europe or Asia or something, and I don't even know where she is, and she's like sleeping on a street in a tent because they're queuing up overnight, or you know, they're running around through fields trying to get into a concert.
A different way of life is fast approaching for Sean when Madonna goes on tour, as well as for Jenny, one of the most devoted admirers of Her Majesty. When that moment approaches, she will hit the road on her own Madonna World Tour.
It looks like I'm at home, but I'm not. I'm on the street, and this is a pillow somebody got from the hotel room for me. And I bought a mattress from a camping shop. Been all over the world at camping shops, particularly in Europe, buying camping gear.
Jenny is a manager at a large residential communications corporation. Her husband is in finance. They seem like any ordinary model English family. Their home is filled with genuine harmony. But everything turns upside down in their household every time a new Madonna album comes out. Jenny jumps at the opportunity to enrich her already considerable collection, which is housed in its own private bedroom in their home.
It's taken some time, many years of collecting. It starts small and then there's always more and more to buy. And I love the imagery of Madonna. She's, you know, a model, a fashion icon. I love these because it's like Madonna history. It's, you know, you see her image changing through the years. She used to write letters in there and other people. And before there was social media, and I was really privileged. This is one of my special issues of Icon, because there was a competition to write an article, and I won, so I'm in the credits down here. And here's my article. I wrote a review about her Dolce and Gabbana fashion shoot. So I'm part of Icon history, so very happy about that. And I won this autograph as a result, so that was signed for me by Madonna.
In addition to that, Jenny can be proud of her ticket collection from past shows. She is only second to her Australian friend Izzy with the number of shows attended.
Holiday! Celebration! Come together! In every nation. That's it, guys.
The end.
Show number 82.
And 42 for me and 44 for you.
Yeah.
Done.
86 for us.
86 between us.
She almost got it right on stage.
Yeah. I've been to, obviously, America and South America, Argentina. I've been to Middle East, to Tel Aviv and Abu Dhabi. I've been all over Europe. Just about every city that Madonna's performed in, Japan, Singapore, Australia, New Zealand.
Can you please tell us like how much roughly it costs?
I can't, I never add it up. I don't know, I don't think we should include the travel because you might travel anyway, so the concert, yeah, it's a lot, but it's worth every penny. You're buying these memories and experiences that I can't put a price on it, so it's a lot.
40 dates in 10 countries covering 3 continents. That is the breakdown of Jenny's latest achievements from the Rebel Heart Tour. It's beyond comprehension to an ordinary non-fan why someone would want to watch the same show 40 times. Even soccer fans don't attend as many games, which are far more different than concert shows.
Every show is quite different, really. if the more you see it, you see we notice costume changes, the different things that Madonna says, the message she gives, it does change at every show. And then you watch the show from different positions, we move around and see it from different angles and then do it all over again. So.
As for Jenny, she looks up to Madonna not just as the queen of pop, but also as a female role model that she could be. The paradox of the mother with a dazzling career of an artist who's also a workaholic and philanthropist.
So I did join a project to raise money and fundraising. I was I oversaw the fundraising. We raised over $200,000 or about £130,000 to buy a brick making machine and build a school in Africa. And my son actually went and helped on it as well. So yeah, she has influenced me. I've thought more broadly because of her.
Just on the way to the second Brisbane show, and I'm here with Elena, Jenny and Rick. Rick's my best friend from Perth, and Jenny is sewing on the run. Isn't she, Jenny?
Yay! Got my needle and thread. I've been sewing for a long time, and it continues, but we're nearly there. And got flowers everywhere.
She's almost done.
I've been sewing from Singapore to New Zealand to Perth to Brisbane, Melbourne. I've been sewing on the way.
But I found I was sewing on planes, on boats, in people's houses while I was travelling. It was just crazy that I had to keep fitting it in between working, going on tour, doing so many shows. Madonna wore this underneath her gypsy style dress and this cape. So this was really fun to wear. I also wore lots of flowers in my hair as well as they did. It was a bit strange leaving the hotel wearing it.
I think the bit it's not troubling, but the bit that I'm not sure Jenny quite understands is how long actually a Madonna tour takes.
In Jenny's mind, the tour is first date to last date, but actually the tour is 12 months before that and 6 months after it as well. It's for 12 months before all her friends, and they're all plotting and planning how they're going to approach it, and then they're buying tickets, and then they're doing this, and then they're doing that. And then for 6 months afterwards, they're all swapping photos and talking about it and doing follow-ups and all that kind of stuff. So the actual duration of a Madonna tour is almost, it's probably about 2 years, you know.
Every wife should be so lucky to have a husband with so much patience as Sean. With every tour, his stock of patience would never exhaust. Tour after tour, Jenny attends more shows than before. She can be out of the country for months at a time. She'll then get back to the family nest for a couple of days, and then fly off to the next destination to flock with her fellow fans for the next several weeks.
It's an odd thing to explain to other people.
Which takes a lot of time. Do you share it with people, really?
Well, we don't hide it. Definitely don't hide it. It's not like you've got a disease or something, is it? It's not a secret, but at the same time, it's not something that you kind of shove down other people's throats either.
It's not easy. I can't just take 6-12 months off. I work in between. I save up my holiday, which is a compromise. It means Sean and I don't have as much holiday together. Luckily, he's very supportive.
So today is your last day in Puerto Rico?
Yeah, it's my last day, so we've just done 2 Rebel Heart shows and really enjoyed the island, but I've got to go back to London now, but only for 2 weeks, because then I'm going to Japan.
In Tokyo, new shows are about to start. In the meantime, the Queen is wrapping up the North American leg of her tour in Puerto Rico, and today her beloved half is coming from London.
What you are thinking when she said to you, like, oh, I'm going to go to visit 44 Madonna show?
I think it's crazy, but I think it's important to her, so it's important to me. It's fine. You can do what you want.
Do you go to Madonna's show as well too? Or you?
I've been to two this tour. Yeah. So that's enough for me.
It's not uncommon for Sean to accompany his wife on the road. In just a week's time, he would be obliged to become familiar with the Asian shows. But when his wife will enter the arena, he will go see the sights. Sometimes he has to sleep alone when Jenny camps outside with other fans to get to the front row.
If you must choose, would you choose Madonna or family?
Oh, family always comes first. sorry, Madonna. But she's very close second. She is like family to me. But my real family come first, of course, and I wouldn't ever do anything, you know, to upset them. But I've managed to balance everything and make it all happen. So it means that I can see Madonna and my family happy.
We're quite independent people. We do different things. So it's not an issue if she wants to go away. It's not an issue if she's off on the tour.
I think got used to it very quickly. I'm very used to having a conversation across the dinner table and realizing the person opposite me is actually buying a ticket and not really listening to me. That's absolutely fine. We're very used to it.
Sean met Jenny in 1990, the same year when Jenny started loving Madonna's music. He dug her scene, her Madonna scene. It goes without saying he would never picture his wife attending 40 shows per tour, but he knew what he was getting himself into. Their first date was at a Madonna concert, Jenny's first ever. The rarest Madonna releases were his first gifts to her. He wanted his wife's collection to be complete, and he knew that this was the key to her heart. He is positive that their relationship is built on trust. We are so different in our passions, and we have the right for our small private corner, even inside our family, when we share sometimes even the craziest traits that can at times be incomprehensible even by ourselves. This is what we call the real love.